हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो दिस इज़ आवर सेशन नंबर 3 फॉर द सब्जेक्ट सर्विंग 2 ऑन द यूनिट नंबर 5 फोटोग्रामेट्री। सो दिस इज़ द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द फोटोग्रामेट्री इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू सी वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स दैट आर बीन आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम्स। ओके, so basically there are four types of the problems. First one is in order to find out the number of photographs. Okay, in that there are two types, subtypes. First one, either when the area is given fully, that is either in terms of square kilometers, it might be 200 square kilometers, 1000 square kilometers directly and not the multiplication. Second type is the multiplication of 10 kilometers into 10 kilometers or 20 kilometers into 20 kilometers. That is the second type of the photograph. Okay, that is finding out the number of photographs. Third type is nothing but to find out the scale of the vertical photograph. And fourth one is the computation of the length of the line AB or PQ on the ground with respect to the coordinates. So we'll see one by one. So first type is, that is the number of photographs necessary to cover a given area. So type 1, so let capital A be the total area to be photographed. So for that purpose, in order to find out the length that has been covered by the photographs for longitudinal overlap is given by the formula capital L is equal to bracket 1 minus PL into bracket complete S into L, where PL is nothing but your longitudinal overlap, which is mentioned in the problem, which I told you in the previous session that it varies between 50 to 60%. Okay, small s is the scale of the photograph and L is nothing but your length of the or size of the photograph. Okay, similarly W, that is the width which has been captured by the photograph. Same formula, bracket 1 minus PW, bracket complete S into W, where this P into W is nothing but your side overlap. Again, small s, same, that is scale of the photograph, and W is the width of the photograph, that is size of the photograph. So the photograph size might be 20 cm by 20 cm, 25 cm by 25 cm, depending upon the size availability. That is the hard prints. Net, so small a is nothing but the net area which has been calculated by multiplying this L which we have calculated, and that is width which we have calculated. And in order to find out the number of photographs that are required, it has been calculated by using the formula capital A divided by small a which we have calculated. So in the problem, the scale of the photograph, size of the photograph, longitudinal overlap and that of the side overlap, it has been mentioned, and the area is mentioned in terms of total square kilometers. So that is the first type. Okay, so as I told you that small l is length of the photograph, width of the photograph, small s is the scale of the photograph. Then type 2, so first of all we are going to see the formulas which are requiring. So type 2, as I told you that there are two types in the finding out the number of photographs. So this is the second type, in which instead of giving the total area in terms of square kilometer, rectangular dimensions, that is length and width of the ground, are given. So for that purpose we are having a different formula, that is number of photographs in the first direction is given by L1 upon capital L plus 1, that is L, the formula which we have utilized previously in order to find out the length of the photographs in one direction. It is same, just changes what. So L1 and L2 are nothing but the length and width of the ground which is to be covered in that direction. Okay, so suppose it has been told in the problem that 10 kilometers by 10 kilometers is the area which has been surveyed by vertical photograph. So in that case, the value of L will be nothing but your 10 kilometer and L2 will be 10 kilometers. Or suppose it has been told that it is 8 kilometers by 12.5 kilometers. So L1 will be 8 kilometers and L2 will be 12.5 kilometers. remaining things, that is PL is longitudinal overlap, S is the scale, L is the length of the photograph, again PW side overlap, W size of the photograph, and similarly S is the scale of the photograph. And finally, in order to find out the number of photographs in such a case, when the length and width of the ground are given, you are just supposed to do the multiplication of this and you will get the number of photographs. So we'll see the problems. So in this case, the question is that a vertical photograph was taken at an altitude of 1200 meters above mean sea level, and they are told to determine the scale of the photograph for terrain lying at elevation of 80 meters and 300 meters if the focal length of the camera is 15 centimeters. So in the problem, they have mentioned the altitude. That is nothing but, we have seen that altitude is nothing but your capital H. This capital H is been mentioned in the problem. Terrain lying at an elevation of 80 meters and 300 meters. So they have mentioned the altitudes. So let this be H1 and let this be H2. And that of the focal length, they have mentioned it as 15 centimeters. That is nothing but small f. And they are told to find out the scale of the photograph. So this is the solution. So as I told you that previously session, that the scale at any height is given by the formula SH is equal to focal length divided by capital H minus small h. Okay. So when small h is 80 meters, which I told you that when h is equal to 80 meters and f is equal to 15 centimeters, just substitute here, okay, the values of f, capital H and small h, you will get the value. Just this 15 is to be divided to this value so that you will get the fraction, that is 1 centimeter divided by 74.67 meters. So they are just told to find out the scale of the photograph and not the representative factors. Okay, so the scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 74.67 meter. Similarly, when the terrain lying is at the height of 300 meters, substitute the value of small h is equal to 300 meters. Again, take this 15 to the bottom and the value will come 60 meters. If you are interested in finding out the representative factor, just you are supposed to make the units same on both the sides so that you will get the RF. That is nothing but your representative factor. Okay, so when this 60 meter is to be converted in terms of centimeters, the value will come out to be 1:6000. Okay, so we will move to the next problem, that is finding out the number of photographs. So this is the problem asked in the paper was that the scale of an aerial photograph is 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters. The photograph size is 20 centimeter by 20 centimeter, and they are told to determine the number of photographs required to cover an area of 100 square kilometer. If the longitudinal lap is 60% and the side lap is 30%. So as we have previously discussed that there are two types of the problems in which you are supposed to find out the number of photographs. First one type is nothing but when the area, net area is given to you, that is in terms of square kilometers and not in terms of rectangular dimensions. So this is the type one problem. Okay, so you can see that in the problem the scale is been given, that 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters. So S value is been given, photograph size 20 centimeter by 20 centimeter, that is nothing but small l and small w they have given. Again, capital A, that is the area which is to be covered, that is 100 square kilometer, it has been given. And the longitudinal lap, that is PL, it is 60% and that of the side lap is 30%. Okay, so you write down the given data. So L, as I told you that size of the photograph 20 centimeter, width 20 centimeter, scale 100, PL, this is 60% in terms of fraction layer taken 0.6, and similarly side lap, which is nothing but your 0.30. Solution. So in order to find out the ground length covered by each photograph, we are having the formula as capital L is equal to bracket 1 minus PL into S into L. So just substitute those values, that longitudinal overlap value is 0.6, scale is 100 and size of the photograph is 20. We will get the value in terms of meters, which are supposed to convert in terms of kilometers. Similarly, calculate the actual ground width covered by each photograph. For that we are having the formula, that is W is equal to the capital W is equal to bracket 1 minus PW into S into W. So the value of PW, that is side overlap, was been mentioned in the problem, that is 30%, converting into fraction, that is 0.3, scale 100 and size of the photograph is 20. The value comes out to be 1400 meters. So likewise of the capital, which we have converted in terms of kilometers, this also we have converted in terms of kilometers. Why? Because the number of photographs that we are supposed to find out, it is nothing but the fraction of total area surveyed divided by the multiplying factor of L into W, that is nothing but covered by our photographs. So the ground area covered by each photograph is nothing but A is equal to L into W, as I told you. So 0.8 is nothing but the length which has been covered, and 1.4, that is nothing but the actual ground width covered by each photograph, which comes out to be 1.12 square kilometers. Okay, and finally, in order to find out the number of photographs required, it is given by capital A divided by small a. So capital A that they are told in the problem, it was nothing but 100 square kilometers. So that just we are supposed to divide it by this 1.12 square kilometers. So we'll get the numbers, as it is the ratio of both square kilometers, that will get cancelled and only the numbers will get. Okay, so this is the first type of number of photographs to find out. Second, okay, that is the number of photograph and type of problem. Third, so you can see that the problem asked is that the scale of an aerial photograph is 1 cm is equal to 100 meter. The photograph size is 20 cm and 20 cm into 20 cm. Determine the number of photographs required to cover an area of 10 km by 10 km if the longitudinal lap is 60% and side lap is 30%. So you can see that almost all data is similar. That is, scale whatever has been given, it was same in that of the previous. That is, then again size of the photograph is same, longitudinal lap 60%, side lap 30%. Only there is change that area is been given in terms of rectangular dimensions, that is length and width, and not total area in terms of square kilometers. So the formula changes here somewhat. Okay, so first of all, similarly, whatever we have followed the steps, we'll write down the given data. So L1 10 kilometers, L2 10 kilometers. Okay, then scale 100 meters, longitudinal lap overlap 60%, that is 0.6, and side lap it is 0.3, that is 30%. Rest of the thing is same, small L 20 centimeter, small W 20 centimeter. Okay, so now we'll see the formula. So we have seen this formula previously. So L1 is nothing but 10 kilometer divided by 1 minus PL into S into L plus 1. So other things what we are having, that are in terms of meters. So correspondingly, we are supposed to convert the size of the length of the photograph, that is 10 kilometers, in terms of meters. Okay, so it becomes 10,000. Remaining part is same, 1 minus PL, it is 0.6, scale 100 into 20 plus 1, so it comes out to be 13.5, which is nearly equal to 14. And the number of photographs in the width direction, so it, the value of L2, they have mentioned it as again 10 kilometers. Similarly, we are going to convert in terms of meters. Okay, so the value comes out to be 10,000. The value of PW, that is side overlap, it has been mentioned, scale 100 and size of the photograph 20 plus 1. So the value comes out to be 8.6, which is nearly equal to 9. And finally, in order to find out the number of photographs required, it is nothing but the multiplying of N1 and N2. So N1 is nothing but your 14, which you have calculated previously here, and N2 is 9. So the multiplication of this gives us the value is equal to 126. The answer is, the number of photographs required is 126 numbers in order to cover the area of 10 kilometers by 10 kilometers. Okay. So this is the change only. Okay. And finally, last type of problem, that is computation of length of the line between points of different elevations from measurements on a vertical photograph. So first of all, I will tell you the theory about this. So O is the position of the aerial camera which has been fitted to the aircraft, and this capital A and capital B are the two points which are located at different elevations on the ground, and of which the coordinates they are getting on the camera as this XA and YA and XB and YB, and that of on the ground actually they are XB, YB and YA and XA. So you can see here the axes are been drawn, that is positive X and positive Y. So moving to the further, so the formula which we are used in finding out the scale of the photograph, it is somewhat similar here, only it is inverse of that. Okay, we'll see that. So we are supposed to find out the lengths of the points A and B which are on the ground, okay, in terms of meters. So in the problem, the altitude, that is capital H, of the flying aircraft is been mentioned. Okay, that is capital H here. Small HA, that is the photograph where it is located at the elevation, and that of the point which is located at point B, that is HB, also is been mentioned, and the coordinates that are been getting, they are also been given. So capital H is been given in terms of meters. Small h is also given in terms of meters. Only the case is that the focal length f, okay, that is of the camera, either it might be given in terms of centimeter or mm, or and that of your the coordinates values, it might be also given in terms of mm or centimeter. So the condition is that you are supposed to convert both the coordinates unit and that of focal length unit same, because the final length will be in terms of meters only. So you are, suppose the coordinates are in terms of millimeter and that of the focal length is in terms of centimeter, either convert the focal length in terms of millimeter or convert this coordinates in terms of centimeters. Okay, so these are the four formulas. So capital H minus HA divided by F into XA, where H is the altitude, that is the photograph placed at the elevation, focal length which is being given in the problem, and XA is the coordinate. Okay, similarly YA, so this is the corresponding for point A and this is correspondingly for point B. Okay, and in order to find out the length L between the two points A and B, it is given by the formula under root XA minus XB bracket square plus YA minus YB bracket square. Okay, so in the problem you will get it cleared out. Okay, so in the problem they are told that two points A and B having elevations of 500 meters and 300 meters respectively above the atom appear on the vertical photograph, having focal length of 20 cm and flying altitude of 2500 meters above the atom. So they are told that the flying elevation of A is 500 meters and that of point B is 300 meters. So the value of HA and small HB is been given. Focal length small f, it is 20 cm and that of flying altitude it is 2500 meters, that is capital H. So they are told that their corrected photographic coordinates were as follows. So for A, the coordinates were plus 2.65 plus 1.36. Small b, it was having minus 1.2 and plus 3.65. So we are going to make utilize the values as it is with their signs. Okay, and they are told to determine the length of the ground line AB. Okay, so given data, it is HA, as I told you, that is elevation of the photograph at 500 meters or the point. Then B, it is at 300 meters. Capital H, is it is 2500 meters, f it is 20 centimeters, and the coordinates xa plus 2.65, xb it is 1.36, ya it is minus 1.2, and yb it is plus 3.65 centimeter, and you are told to find out the length of the ground line AB. So solution, the ground coordinates are given by the formulas. We are knowing that xa is equal to h minus ha divided by f into xa. So capital H, they are mentioned in the problem, it is 2500. Small ha, it is in mention, again focal length and also the coordinates, they have been mentioned here. So h is 2500, that is capital H, 500 is the ha, focal length it is 20, and xa, that is the coordinate xa, it is 2.65. So it comes out to be 265 meters. Similarly, calculate ya. Formula it is h minus ha divided by f into ya. So the value is 1.36, which it is mentioned in the problem, 1.36. Okay. So we'll get the value as plus 136 meter. Okay, next xb, h minus hb divided by f, only the change is here the elevation of the point B were taken into consideration as per the problem. So it is 2500 minus 300 divided by 20 into minus 1.2. so the value of xb, that is coordinate, was minus. It doesn't make a matter, okay, just keep as it is the value minus. Okay, so the value comes out to be minus 211.2 meters. YB, similarly, go on substituting the values, you will get the value equal to 401.5 meters. And finally, in order to calculate the length L between the two points A and B, it is given by, as I told you, that under root XA minus XB bracket square plus YA minus YB bracket square. So the value of XA is 265 and that of XB it is minus 211.2, which we have calculated previously here. Okay. So just substitute that, so this minus minus will become plus, okay, and it is bracket square and it is under root, square root. Again, the value of YA it is 136 and that of YB it is minus 401.5, so again it is in the bracket and we are going to square it, so square of minus it is plus only, and after coming out the square root, the value will come out to be 544.21 meters. So the final answer will be the length L between the two points A and B, it is 544.21 meters. So this was regarding all about the problems which have been asked in the paper in your university exams. If you are having any problem, you can contact me. Thank you.